morning, everyone. You're on Trucker Rudi's channel. And if you stay tuned, you're going to see his daily life and his life on the road. And yep, that's right, I'm his son. And I hope you enjoy.
Today. Yeah. Guess what? We are making our way towards Ottawa. That's correctamente. Yeah, I'm excited.
Continue
because we're
going to
meet up with a very good man today. That's right. Isn't it a gorgeous day? You guys tell me, down there in the comments. Beautiful sunshine this morning, I think. Yes, indeed. Now, these are the days that I start looking forward to be driving, you know? But I'm kind of hoping it's gonna stay like this all day long. Nice and calm, not windy at all. And beautiful sunshine. Like I said, I love driving in a day like this. You know, it's not windy at all. Just a beautiful day all the way around to be out here on the road, cruising along. Perfect time of the year too, because not too many campers are on the road yet, not too much traffic. I mean, yeah, you get a little bit every day, but you know, it's actually pretty good out here. Yeah.
Speed warning.
What are you screaming at me for? I don't know. Sometimes up here in Ontario, the GPS, I guess the satellites are too far away from here and the earth, or I mean in the sky, whatever. And it just feels like sometimes they don't get the right signal, and then he screams speed warning at me, you know? I wasn't even going downhill or nothing, you know? And he thinks I'm going faster than what I'm actually am. And I get all kinds of weird things happening with GPS's up here sometimes. Not all the time, but sometimes it's like if you're just going under an overpass, he screams speed warning. It's just because they didn't get the right coordinates, I guess, from the GPS's up the satellites up in the sky. But yeah. I think we're gonna have us a fantastic day. We only have about five and a quarter hours driving up to Ottawa. So we should be there, well, I mean, it's 7:30 right now, or a little after 7:30. So, yeah, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I would say by 12 o'clock our time, we could be there. So that's 1 o'clock their time. So yeah, we're gonna be there bright and early.
I think
by that time we should have no problem getting us a parking spot. And that's something that I'm worried about, because Ottawa doesn't have a lot of parking there for trucks in the area. So I wanted to try and get there early too, so that way I can get me a good spot.
Park 2 kilometers, slide dry done. Trans Canada Highway 17.
And then we will have all afternoon to meet up with a good friend of ours. And if that's going to happen, that's going to be fantastic. But anyways, we'll continue on with our journey up here. And we appreciate you guys sticking around with me today, hanging out with me, riding along with me. So let's stick around for the rest of the video. And I'm pretty sure it's going to be a good video. Alrighty, guys and gals, here we are in Mattawa, Ontario. Yes. Very interesting place. Yeah, these are the kind of places we have to go when we
continue on this road for 281 kilometers.
Travel to 17 all the way. Yep, we got about 306 kilometers to go up to Ottawa. That should take us about 3 more hours. We got 10 o'clock now. So 10, so 1, 11, 12, 1 o'clock, just after 1 o'clock, we should be there. So, yeah. I mean, we did have us a little bit of a pit stop there a few minutes ago, just before Mattawa there, or just as we come into Mattawa. I probably don't even say that name right, but whatever. It was none other place that I stopped at than Tim Hortons. Yeah. Yep, that's where we stopped at. We stopped at Tim Hortons and went inside and had us a mocha. Yep, and had us a sandwich there. So now we should be good for a good while, right? But yeah, I do screw up sometimes too with my talking. I don't know, I keep having Ottawa on my mind. And yeah. I guess I'm just too excited to go there today. It's been a long time coming and I can't wait. Very excited to go down there, so. Yeah, here we go. Now we're starting to come into some hills. I was talking to my friend Barry earlier and he said, yep, as soon as you leave Mattawa, you're gonna start getting into these big hills. And I guess he was right. As soon as I get across here, we're coming up on this big hill. Yeah. I think what I'm going to try and do is, because I got some pretty good speeds, I'm going to try and go around this truck and then take a left up here. I know normally I wouldn't do it, but since it's going uphill and stuff, I still have plenty enough time to do it in. Then I would do it, but if it looked kind of tight, I wouldn't have done it. For those of you that are right away typing shit or whatever. But anyways, yeah, here we are. Like I said, we got about three and a half more hours to go by the time we get down to Ottawa. Hopefully we can still get us a parking spot.
Speed warning.
I think we should. But anyways, let's continue on cruising along here. Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, here we are in Ottawa. Basically, in town already. Traffic is starting to pick up a little bit. Yes, indeed it is, but that's all right. That time of the day, I suppose, a little bit after two, but always seems to be traffic up here. There was a little bit of a fender bender there on the westbound side there, just before I managed to turn on my cameras. Yeah, welcome to Ottawa, everybody. The place that we don't go very often. I think it's been over a year since I've been down here. So you guys that are new to my channel, you know, this is it. Oh yeah. This is the capital city of Canada. That's right. This is where all the government people work. Yes, indeed that's the case. So, I guess we're gonna move into this lane here. This right lane here, it seems to be moving really slow. I think it's probably because of this truck. He seems to be going really slow, so we'll go get around him and then we'll get back in the right lane, I guess. But yeah, we only got about 12 more kilometers to go, and then we'll be at the truck stop that we want to be at, and then we'll give Jerry Ott a call. Yes, you heard me say that. I'm gonna give Jerry Ott a call and see if he wants to meet up with me still. I already talked to him this morning, and so he said, yep, he is willing to meet up with me. So we'll see if that's gonna happen. I'm sure it will. But yeah, let's get down over there, and I'm excited. I can't wait to go over there and can't wait to see him. I'm waiting for a long time, as I said many times today on my video already. But yeah, that's the truth. So let's get down over there and hope for the best, right?
Hey guys, let's go check this out. Let's see who's here. I believe the man is here. This is going to be a double thing. Yes.
A double thing. Okay. So, hey. First we do the handshake, but you can't see who it is yet. All
yeah,
right. We're
going to
turn.
Right.
You ready? Are you ready? Oh, he's already got his turn. That's not fair.
Yeah.
It's Trucker Rudi.
Hey, everybody.
How's it going? Oh my goodness, I feel really cheap. Look at the setup he's got here.
Yeah.
Holy crap.
Yes.
You think he was a professional videographer or something?
I think. He thinks.
I know I'm not. Anyways, yeah, hey. We're here with the famous Trucker Rudi.
Yeah, right.
Who got to go to Matt's and
hey,
I
Linda.
Hey, nice to meet you.
Oh, hey.
You get to meet Linda too.
Yes, that's right.
Although I think
How
they
are you?
Talk more
Good.
On Facebook
Can't
than
complain.
I do.
Yeah, yeah, you're a little Facebook shy.
I stay away from it.
It's because you're so busy playing games.
Oh, yeah, that's right. don't tell nobody, right? So
anyway, we're going to chat here. We'll be back in a minute. Maybe. I don't know. Probably.
Who knows, right? So you guys want to go for coffee or something?
Yeah. Timmy's.
Your son's back home?
Yeah. Yeah, he is.
Alrighty, guys. Here we are with Jerry Ott at Tim Hortons. And hey, look at that, guys. We got some questions for him, and I'm sure you guys would mind hearing from him a little bit too. So how's
it's a scary
your,
thought. It's a very
your,
scary thought.
It's a very scary thought, eh?
Yep. He hunted me down. He found me. I had to come out.
That's
I came
right.
out of hibernation.
Yeah, it's been a...
Don't shake the table. See, they don't know who we're talking to.
Yeah.
Oh, mind you, they might have seen her walk up from behind.
Probably. Unless you covered the whole...
I covered the whole thing.
But how's your recovery going so far?
It's slow, but it's getting there.
Yeah.
It's finally in the upward swing, if you will.
Yeah.
So, got still a month or two of, I won't call it physio, but exercise.
Why did you decide to get into YouTube?
It wasn't as much YouTube as it was trying to do videos to help new drivers. There was nothing out there but negative feedback, like anything you saw on YouTube in regards to trucking was either someone bitching, moaning, or complaining about the industry, and nobody really out there trying to help anyone.
Okay.
So I just thought I'd do originally it was just supposed to be a small series of videos, you know, to show people what life was like in the truck, and ended up, you know, 4 years later.
So you've been doing
well,
it
except for the
years?
Last 6 months now, seven
yeah.
months, I haven't kind of stopped taking a break.
Yeah. Okay.
Trying to, you know, get my priorities
straight
in order as far as my health. So, although looking at me, you can't tell right now.
Watch priorities, right?
I got crumbs on me too. He made me eat a donut.
Yeah,
so,
right.
But you know.
What makes your videos different than other YouTubers?
I don't know that mine are any different. They're just my point of view.
Okay.
I mean, there's like yourself. There's I won't mention any names because I don't know who you like or who you endorse or who you don't
yeah.
endorse. But there's a good number of people out there. I found since I started doing it, there's been a few people that said, oh, I can do it better, or they wanted to give their point of view. And I think that's all it really is. It's not that one person's better than another. It's just a different point of view.
Yeah.
The way I see it may not be the way you see it. Or you may see something that I'm not putting in that you see different that could be of interest too.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I think everyone just has their own spin on it. You know, you've got a few people that are husband wives out there doing videos.
Yeah, I know who you're talking about.
Former and current.
Yeah.
The former, well, anyway. but the current ones, that. They, you know, they do a good job, I think. And there's a few.
Well, I think you do a good job.
There's a few solo drivers that are doing things. Everyone does their own perspective on the industry, and I think the majority of them are positive. There's one or two.
Yes.
That are still negative, and I don't think should even be on the air because none of their stuff is valid.
Yes.
It's true. More like they're out there looking for trouble and trying to post that.
Well, there's always people like that out there, right?
I mean, that goes out without saying with everything, but it's like we're trying to put a positive spin on
the trucking industry
where they're purposely trying to find the bad. Yeah, the trucking industry isn't so great anymore. As far as the new age driver.
Yeah, I've always said if you look hard enough, you're going to find bad in anything, right?
There's always bad apples, and that's the problem.
Yeah.
You're talking an industry thing in the U.S., there's over 3.5 million drivers. Canada, there's over 360,000 drivers. So, I mean, yeah, there's a big difference between the two, but that's a lot of drivers or a lot of employees for one base industry, you know, and that doesn't include, you know, office personnel, warehouse staff, and things like that.
Yeah.
That's just drivers, so.
What audience do you think are you attracting?
I found over the years, originally I thought it was people that just wanted to get into the industry, but, I mean, we've got people, as yourself does, I mean, people that have retired and drove for 40, 50 years that are there, seeing what it's like now versus when they were in. You've got young kids that are 15, 16 years old trying to decide to see if, you know, this is a future that they want to do. I mean, because let's face it, everyone has a kid. You grew up, you watched. Yeah. For us, anyway, now that, I mean, they're watching reruns of these, but, you know, you watch Smokey and the Bandit, you watch BJ and the Bear, you watched Convoy and all these trucking movies, and it's like, oh, I want to be a trucker. Right?
Yeah, that used to be, like, it was a cool thing, right?
Yeah, but you know what? You know, the reality of trucking, it's nothing like Smokey and the Bandit. It's nothing like any of these trucking movies that were out there. It's the exact opposite, actually.
Yeah.
There is no, let's drive from, you know, or what was it, Arkansas to Texas and you know.
And 24 hours. Yeah,
28 hours there and back, you know. Yeah. That's just not going to happen by yourself.
yeah. And what do you do to interest people in watching your videos and or do or say to make it more interesting?
I just try to be myself.
Okay.
People say I ham it up for the camera, even when it's Linda and I in the camera. They say, oh, you guys are just, you know, making that up.
Yeah.
But you know what? No.
That's the way we are.
That's just the way we are. And that's, I think, the way everyone should be. I mean, if you're going to do YouTube or anything as far as videoing, just be yourself.
Mm-hmm.
People are either going to like you or they're going to hate you.
That's right.
There's always going to be the trolls that are going to hate you, and they're going to do everything possible to.
I've seen that on my channel.
Yeah.
I'm sure you've seen it on yours.
You know, when I was small, and there was only I only had maybe a 1,000 viewers or so. You never saw them. You know, I was a nobody. Nobody. They didn't bother with me.
Yeah.
But the second you get a little bit of popularity and you start growing, they seem to come out of the woodwork.
So, anyway.
You can't get rid of them.
What kind of advice would you have for people that are looking to get into the trucking industry?
Do your research. That's a big thing, is the research. A lot of people aren't doing it. And again, they're coming into it thinking that they're going to make $100,000, you know, their first year out, when that's just not going to happen. You got to put in the time, just like the construction industry. You go in as a carpenter, guess what? You're not going to be framing that house right away.
Ooh.
You know, you're not the one that's going to decide where the walls go and how that frame goes. No, you're the one that's going to be picking up the scrap.
Yeah, no kidding.
And bringing the head carpenter his tools, you know.
Yeah, yeah. If you're planning on getting back into it, or your health will allow you to get back into the trucking industry, would you go with the same company as you are, as you were?
That's the plan.
Yeah.
If I do go back on the road, I may, if I make the decision to go back on, I'll probably go back on a running Intercan again, like I did for a short while there, which is just basically Ontario, Quebec. Okay. You know, stay out during the week, come home in between to do my resets.
Okay.
Just keep me close to home.
Yes.
I mean, there's more than just my health. There's got family members with health issues, so
exactly.
I just want to stay close to home and go
next
slow.
Next question I had here was, anyways, how does your family feel about you going back on the road?
Okay, that laughter should give it away right there.
Yeah.
I'm ready.
She would be ready to do the happy dance. But
after 6 months of being on the road and really our whole married life, mm-hmm. Jerry's never really been home all the time.
No.
You know, before he did trucking, he was doing towing. So I'd come home from work, he'd be out.
Yeah.
You know, and he'd come home early in the morning, and then, you know, and then from then that heavy tow trucks and stuff.
Okay.
So I mean, he was really never always home, and it's like,
yeah, it's always out doing something.
We're really not used to being together 24/7.
Yeah, living together 24/7 right now has its challenges.
Yeah, we've been.
I try to be a good house husband, but then she beats me.
Yeah, all right. Do you have any particular goals for your YouTube channel in the future?
Actually, I'm trying to work that out right now as to which direction I want to go.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, Big Rig Talk, I pretty much narrowed it down to just a few videos a month, and it always has to do with something, whether it be teaching, showing tips or tricks, things like that. I did away with the daily vlogs on that channel quite a while back, and I started up Molly and Me.
Yes, I have.
Which doesn't have quite the following, but mm-hmm. it was more because
it's
people
more
were
about you and your dog, right?
Yeah, me, the dog, and then also with Linda on the weekends when I was home and stuff. More like Comedy Central type deal. But because people were complaining, like, you know, what is me and, because I don't know, there wasn't a lot to show. I was limited to what I could show as far as driving goes.
Yeah.
And like I kept telling people, trucking isn't necessarily about the scenery.
That's right.
Even though it is, I mean, that's a big part of it. You get to see a lot.
Yes.
But, I mean, there's only so much scenery you can show.
Yeah.
You know, watch the Travel Channel.
Yeah, no kidding. What have been some of the highlights of your YouTube career and the downside of YouTube career? What have been some of those?
The downside is, well, I don't know if it's a downside, you've got to grow really thick skin. If you don't have thick skin, and at first it was a little tough dealing with the negativity. It's like people trashing on you and you're like, but what did I do? You know? The upside is the positive feedback you get.
Yes, I mean, I've noticed that too.
We've got quite a good following both on Facebook and whatnot. I mean, whether it be a birthday or my surgery, the amount of support that's there is really, really good. So
people that you end up getting to know from other countries and, you know,
people
you've
never met.
Something that I don't think you'd ever really get
I was born in Bolivia myself, so I'm from South America too, you know?
Yeah.
Well, that's what I mean. It's diversified. We met you.
A lot of nice people out there.
There's just so many people that you meet online.
Yeah.
That are good people, so that just is good for the soul, if you will, not to be philosophical or anything, but
is there anything that you would like to see different in the YouTube community?
I'm really not sure. See, I wasn't one that never went to any of the YouTube gatherings.
Mm-hmm.
A few other YouTubers did, and I found it actually changed them.
Yeah.
And I don't know if it was for the better.
Mm-hmm.
So in that sense, I just want people to not be full of themselves.
Yes.
And think they're better than
and
other people.
Else,
and I'm not trying to name anyone in particular.
Yeah.
This goes for other people that I watch too that have nothing to do with trucking. You can see I follow several people from when they were really little. mm-hmm. to the way they are now.
Yeah, and it seems like it changes people,
It changes people. So I'd like to see people just, you know what, YouTube's not going to last forever as far as our popularity goes.
Exactly,
It's going to level off, and then it's going to die off. So just enjoy it while you can, enjoy the ride, and make the most of it without, you know, tearing down the little people, if you will.
So what do you do on your time off to keep yourself busy?
You really want to know that answer?
Well, we know already that from your videos that you do play a lot of video games.
Yeah, probably too much.
Probably?
No, there's no problem. No probably involved in that. That's a whole lot too much video games. But now that summer's here, and now that I've been cleared with my chest and being able to actually get out and do stuff, I'm hoping to start being a little bit more,
being able to direct
finding a table in a I'm trying to find a table that can be in the shade outside and I can have my computer outside instead of inside. But no, I'm trying to try to start getting outside a little bit more and get off the computer, and just because, I mean, it's tough. You go all winter. Number one, it's winter.
It's so hard to go outside.
Going outside, you're not going to go.
Yeah.
Number two, being restricted to not being able to do anything.
Yeah.
And a lot of people say, oh, come on, you have to been able to do something. No, really.
Yeah.
They gave me shit for vacuuming.
Well, if the doctor tells you, you know, you're not supposed to do anything, I always say, too, if there's so many people that don't follow that, and then later on...
Well, and that's my, my chest. Actually, the incision was closing, and it started to reopen because I was doing too much. And I really wasn't doing much. If anything. So it was literally, my days consisted of getting up, making coffee, having cereal, sitting in front of the computer, get up, let the dogs out, go back to sitting behind the computer.
If you were not able to go back to trucking, what kind of career would you want to do?
Professional house husband.
Professional house husband.
See, she's just not buying it, man.
I'm not paying you for that.
Damn, but you make such good money, though. Oh, well. I don't know if I can't go back to long haul. Well, it all depends on what the doctors say. If I don't pass and I can't drive trucks again, there's always something. Like, I mean, I can drive a car again now. They did give me permission for that.
Okay.
So as far as that end goes, I could do well.
He mentioned it already.
I mentioned Uber. She said no. Actually, it's funny because the city of Ottawa is actually buckling down on that.
Oh, really?
So Uber is out of the question, unfortunately.
Oh, boy. Okay.
But I'm sure I can find something.
No.
No, Uber's out of the question for me.
Oh, okay.
Well, because they now want anyone that's going to be... You have to be properly licensed now.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Like a regular taxi.
Like a regular cab. So what's the point?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Okay.
So you're going to have to pay special insurance. You're going to have to get special licensing.
Yes. Yeah.
And you know they're going to charge a fortune for that.
If you guys could go on vacation, where would you guys take?
For the... Together?
Yeah.
Or separately?
Well, since you guys are here together, why not?
Well, my spot would be the pier in Florida, in Naples. I don't know where Linda's spot would be, but the pier is with a fishing pole in my hand. But.
Yeah. Beside the pool in Naples.
Yeah, she'd be at the pool in Naples.
Yeah, we went on a cruise there a couple of years ago, and from Florida there.
Yeah.
That was very nice.
Yeah.
I mean, we have free accommodation.
We've talked about going on a cruise at some point. But
we've talked about other things, but we always end up in Florida.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It's free. So,
other
than getting down there, it's free. So, I like free.
Although, we'd like to next year go to England.
Yeah, we
want
to try to get to England because of Jess being in England now. So,
okay. Well, okay.
It's kind of her new residence.
Okay.
Oh, empty like nest syndrome went to a whole new level. She didn't just move out of the house. She moved out of the country. Off the continent.
Well, I actually did that too when I grew up or when I got married. My parents were still in Paraguay when I moved here.
Yeah.
So they came a year after.
Oh, really? Yeah?
Yeah.
To live? Yeah.
Yeah. And then a year after that, my sister came as well.
Oh, really?
But they moved back to Paraguay already. But my parents are
still warm.
Well, I guess because her husband was a little more wealthier, and he had a cattle ranch up there and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So he felt more home over there. Out here, over here, he had to actually go have an 8-to-5 job, you know, and over there.
Yeah.
You know, cattle ranch, it's maybe a few hours a day here and there, but
yeah,
that's it, right? So, you know, he's over there. I mean, they came to visit us last year, but
yeah,
which was nice, but... What type of videos would you do if you wouldn't be able to go back into the trucking industry?
It's another topic we were just discussing, and I'm thinking that if I don't go in and watch, actually we're going to probably start soon, just for the interim, is just our Linda's and I normal daily rants and kibitzing and hijinks, if you will.
There you go.
And see if that generates any interest. As to which channel it'll go on, I'm not sure.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, Big Rig Talk is supposed to be about trucking.
Yes.
So, I may occasionally do a video on there, too, because I know the network has actually sent me an email wondering, you know, what's going on, how things are.
Okay.
So, because...
Yeah, I've noticed you're partnered with Full Screen, eh?
Yes. Partnered with Full Screen. They've done a fairly good job.
Yeah.
So, like I said, they sent me an email to see... what's going on and, you know, what we're going to be doing. My contract is over with them, but I've just stayed with them because I was only obligated to 2 years.
2 years, yeah. I'm currently with Freedom, and they don't have no contract.
Yeah.
So I kind of like that. They give me a lot of free music as well.
Yeah. Well, that's the advantage of being with a network. Plus, yeah, you get a little bit of protection as far as any copyright strikes and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So... there's a few added bonuses.
Yeah.
I could do a lot more through Full Screen, but I just don't participate in all their programs. So.
Yeah, well, you know, you can't participate in everything, right?
No, and like I said, we'll see what happens and which way I go. So we might end up just, you know, redoing Molly and Me and rename it and just reformat everything there. And even though it's a smaller channel, smaller audience right now. But,
It doesn't mean it has to stay that way.
Well,
right?
What I might do too is with Big Rig Talk is, I mean, there's a number of dealerships here in town that I can go and do, you know, reviews or talk to them, talk to mechanics and stuff like that.
Oh, that would be
so
interesting.
There are some things that I can do. Mm-hmm. I've got some ideas as far as talking to other parts of the trucking industry.
Oh,
a lot of people seem to think, and that was one of the things I ran into, a lot of people seem to think that over the road is the only trucking that's out there.
Yeah.
Oh, it didn't work for me, so I'm going to quit and go back to my office job. Why?
Mm-hmm.
So many other aspects to trucking than just over the road.
Well,
so.
Yeah, I mean, there's dispatching planners and everything.
Well,
right?
There's driving cement trucks, dump trucks, gravel slingers.
All kinds of.
You name it. There's all kinds of trucks out there. So
yeah,
garbage trucks, working for the city, making a pension and good money, which, you know, I don't.
All right, I think that just about wraps my questions up. I don't want to hold you up all evening. I know you guys have some other plans. So anything else you would like to say before we go?
Watch and subscribe to Trucker Rudi. He's the best.
There you go. Thank you. I will also leave the link down in the description box for you guys so you can check
to Trucker Rudi.
Yeah,
it'll be down in the description.
To Jerry Ott. He's got two channels anyways, so we'll leave both of them links down there below.
Thank
for
you.
For you guys, and I, you know, might be a few people that don't know about you from that I have.
It's always possible. Yep. It's always possible.
So,
and we'll do the same on ours when our video that we haven't done in now. It's got to be a month now since the last update.
Yeah.
So.
So thanks for meeting up with me, guys.
Thank you very much.
So
thank you
for calling us.
Yeah, no problem.
Damn! I can't see.
Well, guys, it is time to say goodbye to these ladies and gentlemen.
There's a lady here. Now, if I could only see.
There we go.
There we go.
Oh,
shade.
Good thing I'm so big, right?
Tall.
I'm the big one. You're the tall
big
one.
There
we go. Yeah. Make sure we get that right.
It was
all
nice
right.
Meeting you guys.
Nice meeting you, Rudi.
Yeah.
It was great meeting you.
Thank you.
Oh, look, you're on camera.
You're on camera.
No drama?
No drama?
No drama.
Oh.
Not a drama queen.
Not really, like now.
Apparently.
I didn't
all
do
right.
My hair.
Oh, no. Edit.
Cut. Anyways, we're out of here.
Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen. We are done with our day now.
We have had ourselves a fantastic meeting with Jerry Ott and Linda Ott with his wife. Yes, that was fantastic, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video as much as I did, or, well, at least I got to meet him in person, right? But you guys are getting to see it through the lens. Yeah, through my videos. Yes, isn't that fantastic or what? Well, if you guys enjoyed the video and you like to check these guys out, I'll leave the links right down there in the description box. And I sure hope that you guys are going to go check him out. And if you like what you see from his videos, hit that subscribe button there in the corner of his video. Yes, I'm sure he's going to appreciate it. And let them know that I sent you guys their way. I'm pretty sure they're going to appreciate that, guys. And hey, if you like their video, share their video. And also give it a big fat thumbs up. You know how the routine goes. If you're here on YouTube watching YouTube videos, I'm sure you know how it goes. So with that being said, we are done for today. We're getting ready to render these videos. So I figured I would finish off this video today. I've had a fantastic day. I know it's probably a little shorter of a video of a driving, but we did have a lot of footage from us meeting up there. So yeah, I'm happy. I've been waiting for this for over a year. Oh yeah, I've been wanting to meet Jerry Ott for a very, very long time. So we finally made it happen. Yes, although it's not in the best circumstance. Anyways, it's not the best for him because he's sick, or, you know, maybe not really sick, but he had some health issues and stuff like that. So he's going through a bit of a rough time right now. But hey, we did have us a good visit with him and good talk. And who better to check him out than you guys, right? And we had good coffee. That was awesome. And with that being said, we are going to get out of here. We got a delivery to make here tomorrow morning. So we're going to edit this video and put it together for you guys. And be sure to hit the subscribe button and give us a big thumbs up. And we'll be back tomorrow. That's for sure. Unless something happens, right? So this is Trucker Rudi signing out. We're out of here. Goodbye. Behind me, that day is gonna come.